previously on Real Husbands of Hollywood.
Look, Kev, we've been dating.
To Bridget and Nelly, may he love you better than I ever did.
My God, you're beautiful.
Yeah, I know.
It would be a sin to not use your beauty to spread the word.
As we pass along the plate of generosity, cash only, ain't no ATM in heaven.
Hey, man.
Did you just smack my ex-wife? A heart-pumped ass? What the f***?
Oh!
This is the life. This is the life. That's the life. That's the life. This is the city where we party every night. Every night. You and me. Diamonds and gold. Welcome to Hollywood. Welcome to Hollywood. Welcome to Hollywood.
Yeah. Watch this stuff. Oh, Gillum. Oh.
We're over here, Kevin.
KJ! Yay! What's up, man? You look good, boy. What the hell is Nelly doing here? Why's my son dressed like a St. Looney Tune?
The real question is, why are you in those Philly colors? 76ers haven't been good since 76.
Good. Hey, look, that's neither here nor there. He should be dressed in his dad's favorite team's colors.
But, Daddy, that's basketball.
And we're here to sign him up for baseball, fool.
What?
Baseball.
Let me talk to you for a second. Come here, boy. Maybe I'm crazy, but I kind of swore that you called me out here to sign him up for Little League B-Ball. Everybody knows that B-Ball stands for basketball.
Actually, Kevin, B-Ball can stand for baseball, too.
I'm not rapping to you.
You know what, Kevin? You're just confused because they both have B.
No, I'm confused at the two B's standing in front of me.
Come on. Come on, Kevin. KJ wants to play baseball. It's a national pastime, man. What's wrong with that?
Just like you? Past your time?
That is so disrespectful.
Don't worry about it.
Daddy? Nelly said I can be the next Matt Holliday.
Okay, son, come here. He's not even black, all right?
Kevin, why don't you just shut your little ass up? What you're doing is you're embarrassing us in front of all of these white people out here. That's not how we do.
No, what's embarrassing is you coming out here wearing Eddie Murphy's pants from Delirious.
What? Don't be mad. I don't know how to keep my man, and all these women who are listening to this conversation can take a hint.
Okay, here's the point. Now, everybody knows that my son wants to be in the NBA. Wanted to be a little NBA point guard ever since I put him inside you.
No, I thought you was an NBA point guard when I let you up inside me, acting like Stud Webb, looking more like Nate Hobbit, son. That's the last time I let a little no-count Negro have my number at the All-Star game. Okay. That was a snake move.
Yeah, whatever.
You did.
Hey, we both thought I was going to the league. Both of them. Wait, what are y'all looking at?
What are y'all looking at?
You up in our business.
We talking over here.
These black people problems.
You know what? Just let it go. I'm signing him up for baseball. Come on, KJ.
We signing my seed up for no baseball.
Watch.
That's my seed.
Watch.
Wow, this is awesome. Hey, look, Kevin. I know KJ's your son and all that, man. But he wants to play baseball, and I can teach him how to play the right way. I got you.
I'm about to teach you how to dodge a ball the right way.
Boris preaching at Pastor Blunt's church, I thought he was good, but he wasn't ready for the big time until he healed crazy-ass Regina. Ever since then, offers have been pouring in for him to speak at churches everywhere, from First AME to the 16th Chapel. So you know me. I made Boris an offer that he couldn't refuse.
I want you to imagine it's Sunday, and this place is packed with fools, okay? I mean, followers, right? And what are they following? They're following you, B. Mm. And when they're finished praising you, guess what they're gonna be buying? Oh. Our caps, T-shirts, onesies. This is a can't-miss business opportunity. I mean, blessed opportunity, Boris. What do you think?
Ah, this is crazy. I'm checking out.
But think about your flock.
I'm thinking about my flock. You're thinking about your pockets.
No, I'm thinking about the word, Boris, okay? I was blind, and you opened my eyes. I didn't land on Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ landed on me, Boris.
Yeah, my church is gonna be non-denominational.
That's fine.
And who's gonna pay for all of this anyway?
He will provide, Boris, and you should know that. Now, let me show you something. This is a built-in tithing machine. See?
John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. John 3:16, Duane.
Wow. Boris, you just made me a believer, man. Now, you know, if you can make a believer out of me, that's gotta be a sign.
Yes, yes, yes.
Tell me you're in.
If I can convert you, I can convert the world. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah! Woo! Good thing I remembered that scripture. Finally, that one day in Sunday school paid off.
Yo, so listen. So I go to the park, right? Of course, in my mind, I'm thinking I'm going there for my little son in this little basketball tournament. Instead, what do I find? Nelly, AKA steroid dude, he's there signing my son up for baseball.
Well, you know Nelly was drafted by the Cardinals, right?
Yep.
Hmm. Same way you were drafted by the Knicks?
Look, Kev, don't hate. You just mad because I did the garden before you.
Wow. Weird thing is, I have proof about mine. What about you?
Ticket sales. Hey. Burn.
It doesn't even matter, man. He needs to draft himself a son. How about that? Leave my damn son alone, dude. I'm starting to get mad.
Kevin, look, we're all children of the Almighty. We're part of the same family. Mm. No need to get angry. No.
Boris, real quick, in the Bible, what's it say in chapter 3, verse, shut the f*** up?
Really?
Please. God, he's just killing me, man, with all these Jesus quotes. Let me ask you a question, Boris. If Jesus loved you, why didn't he tell you to get the rest of your mustache?
Huh? Your mustache?
Yeah, your mustache. What did Jesus do with that?
Look, Kev, this is not ransom, okay? This is not, give me back my son!
Dude, you know, it's funny to y'all because it's not your kid. Is somebody coming over my house for y'all?
Maybe. No, he's worried he's getting his son taken.
Let's see, would you react the same if it was your son, Duane? That's what makes me laugh.
Oh,
speaking
man.
Of the damn devil.
Nelly can have my son. What up, baby?
Mo, Nels, what up?
I'm good,
finally.
Man.
Sorry I'm late. Game winning the extra inning.
Oh, you went to the Dodger game?
Yeah, man. Cardinals got in that ass. And my man, KJ, had a great time, too.
That's mighty nice of you
to do that. You took my son to his first baseball game?
Well, not actually his first baseball game. We went to one last week. Yo, he enjoyed it. Boy caught a foul ball. Only taught him one time.
What?
Wait, whoa, he's dope.
Okay.
Whoa. You got a good kid.
Stop though. It. Stop it. You taught my son how to catch?
Yeah, balls and girls. Teach him how to hit next week, too.
Nice.
Teach him how to hit.
Yeah.
He's gonna teach him how to hit next week.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Maybe if you teach him how to hit like this.
Oh, strike one.
Yeah, what's it? Strike.
Stop. What are you doing?
What are you doing?
Okay. Maybe I need to calm down. Yeah. I will! You stop!
Oh no!
Oh! Kev!
I'm alright!
You sure?
Yeah, pigeon broke my fall.
Alright, good.
Alright. It fell over another ledge. Yeah.
Hurry up, man.
Come on. Watch yourself. All right, son. Daddy is about to show you how to hit a pitch.
But what happened to Uncle Nelly?
Hey, I said hit a pitch, not a Mitch. That's your problem, son. You don't listen. Pay attention. Little secret. The bigger the bat, that's how you hit your home runs. In baseball and in love. That's what I did to your mother. You were a double. If you had been a little bit taller, you'd have been a home run. I called Charlie Horse. All right, son. I'm a little loose now. That's how you warm up. That's how all the pros actually warm up.
But Daddy, you missed every ball.
I missed every ball on purpose. Because I'm warming up. I gotta get my shoulders loose. Now I'm about to speed this thing up. Turn it up to about 95. Watch what happens now.
But Daddy, Uncle Nelly said you have to wear a batting helmet.
Hey, let me tell you something. Batting helmets are for batters who swing both ways, like your Aunt Nelly. Pay attention, boy. These things are going. Oh, hold on. Hey, stop. Son.
I told you.
And can I get a witness? Remember, through love and kindness, we learn that there are no plateaus, only higher peaks, and that we must embrace that power. Don't leave before the miracle, brother.
Bad hair day.
That energy and opportunity to achieve grace on earth. Because life is beautiful. Now go in peace, my brothers and sisters. Amen.
All right, see you next week. All right, Bruce.
All right, everybody, we got these t-shirts and souvenir mugs. We got sweatsuits. They're breakaway.
So, that went well. We got a few converts. What do you think?
I think if Jesus had a turnout like this, our money would say, in Satan we trust.
Look, I told you we're non-denominational.
Well, apparently we're non-donational too, Boris. Look, that's all we got, okay? You were talking for 90 minutes, and not once did you push the t-shirts, the wristbands, or the mugs, or the bobbleheads. This is what this is all about, Boris. And you know what? Not once did you mention a finger. And what's with this free communion, Boris? We agreed that no communion ticket, no communion. This is not a happy hour, Boris.
Okay, look. You gotta have some faith in me.
Of course, I have a lot of faith. I have a lot of faith that this is not gonna work out for us, man. Oh, I'm working hard here.
Don't throw in the towel just yet.
Oh, now you wanna mention the towels, huh? Here they are. You want the towels? There's the towels, Boris.
Duane, this is not about the money.
Oh, well, you know, I already know that, Boris. I know you're not about the money. Everybody knows that about you, because there's no way you did the gospel for the money.
Look, it's our mission to awake the sleeping inner giant, to help people realize their spiritual potential, all right? It's not about the towel. It's not about the bobblehead. It's not about the t-shirt. What is this, feminine wash? Are you kidding me? It's not about material possessions. I don't need any of this. I don't need any of this. Nothing, absolutely nothing.
Hey, man, you ain't gotta throw the jersey.
In Boris, we trust.
Son, spread your hands apart. That's too close. Yeah, a little further. Can you put them a little further than that? There you go.
Uncle Nelly said I have to put my hands together.
Nelly don't know what he's talking about.
Put your hands together, KJ.
Hey,
you're doing it right.
First of all, what are you doing here, man?
KJ texted me. He said he needed some help.
That's a lie. KJ can't text you because KJ's not allowed to have a phone.
Uncle Nelly gave me one, Daddy.
Nelly what?
He gave me one.
You gave my son a phone, man?
I mean, no, technically I didn't. It was Father and Son Day at Dodger Stadium. They were giving out free phones. So if you want to be mad at Magic.
You got the phone on you, son?
Yes, sir.
Let Daddy see it.
Phone, Kevin.
This is it right here? Step over there.
No.
So you better sit down.
Kevin, don't hit his phone, Kevin. Wait, what are you? Strike two.
First of all, strike one, so learn your strikes.
No, that shirt was strike one.
You don't understand respect. You're gonna learn it.
Help.
No, you're not trying to help. I'm gonna show you what your help gets you.
Yo, Kev.
Dude, can you please hush?
No, but what I'm about to tell you.
Let me discipline my son, please.
Bye. Stand back, KJ.
Hey, son, was that a fair or foul ball? Go ahead, make the call. That's right, you can, because you don't have a phone, do you?
Daddy?
Yes, son.
That was your fault.
What you? Oh! I knew that was my phone. I was just trying to teach the boy a lesson. Always have two phones. Anybody got some D batteries?
Okay, Boris, just come on.
Slow down, Duane.
No, this is gonna be great. I got you covered, man. You gotta trust me on this.
I'm not into that.
Okay, you can take it off now.
What?
I knew you would love it, Boris.
No, that's not what I meant. I made a deal with God, not with Playgirl.
No. You have a deal with Google. Listen, every time the letter B is searched, these babies pop up.
I don't want them to pop up. I want them to disappear. This is not good.
Don't you get it? The symbolism of it all. Your body is a temple, Boris.
The only symbol I care about is dollar sign.
B, come on, man. Listen, I believed in you, right? So now I need you to believe in me at this point.
I want to believe in you, but I can't. Look at the pictures. I can't be naked in a church.
Yes, you can.
It's wrong.
Yes, you can. Thank you so much. Great. Hey, everybody, it's time to open for business.
No, wait a minute. What do you think? This is beautiful. And it's only Tuesday.
I'm in.
And I'm in too. Woo! I make it rain on myself.
Nice catch, third base. You ain't gonna make it to the league like that, though. Hey, what, you killing raccoons now?
I'm about to kill a rat right now.
Attitude, that's your problem.
Hey! Hey, Daddy!
What's up, man? Oh, blow it up. Put a chain on it. Pad the... I'll teach you the rest later. I got something for you.
Really? What is it, Dad?
Oh, it's a special glove. This belonged to your daddy when he played Little League Baseball.
I thought you hated baseball.
Only at nighttime. During the daytime, I love it. I went and got it signed by Eric Davis. That's a legendary pitcher.
Where'd you get that glove from, Kevin? The secondhand store?
Same place you got that wig from.
You know what? I will ball your face
up. Oh, my God. Don't talk to me without gum.
Don't you tell me.
Take your bad breath and throw it away.
Shut up. Thanks, Daddy.
You talk to your son.
Thanks, Daddy. It's awesome.
I knew you would love it.
Speaking of awesome, hey, baby.
Hey. Hey, how you doing?
Uncle Nelly, I didn't think you were going to come.
Yeah, neither did I, because I told you not to.
Well, I did, okay?
Well, you shouldn't.
Would never miss your day, man. And I brought my good friend, Mr. Eric Davis.
How you doing, KJ?
Eric Davis? My dad just gave me an autograph of him, and now you're here. He said you were one of the best pitchers ever.
Pitching? No pitch. I was an outfielder.
Son, I said a pitch. I said I got a picture of.
You said you was a pitcher, like
throw. I'm talking to my son. I'm talking to my son.
Talk to him.
I'm talking to my seed.
Don't lie, though.
Let me see this glove.
No. You don't need it. Look at this one. Look at this glove.
Come on. Back up.
Kev, that's not my signature.
What?
There's no O in Eric. What's wrong with your boy, Nelly?
Now, wait a minute. I'm not crazy. That wasn't you at Starbucks?
No.
Ice whip frat.
No.
Hey, I want you guys to be on the lookout for our beautiful vodka. We're dropping it this Easter.
Boris?
Beautiful outfit, yes.
Sign my temple.
Your temple.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, of course I will sign your temple.
Oh, what are you doing?
I'm just communing with my flock.
That's a flock of Boris. You're killing our bottom line.
Are you suggesting I charge for my signature?
Of course, man. It costs to get into the kingdom.
Are you out of your mind?
Yes, I'm out of my mind. That'll be $50 for the signature, man.
Okay.
It doesn't seem right, Duane. I can't do that.
You know what, Boris? I like the way you think. That'll be $100 for the signature, ma'am.
Okay. Do you take EBT cards?
Of course we take EBT. We take American Express, Visa. We even take the Rush card. Uncle Rathbelt. He will love this. Here you go. Boris, do you understand what's going on here? You stick with me, and I will make you the first prophet to make a profit. Now sign her.
Give me a K. Give me a J. That's my baby. He gonna hit it anyway. You got it, KJ. Show that boy how it's done.
Come on, KJ. Take your time. Put your elbow up.
No, KJ, put your elbow down like I told you.
Come on now. Bend your knees.
No, KJ, stand straight up.
Baby, tuck your shirt in.
Don't tuck your shirt in.
He looks sloppy.
Wait for your pitch.
No, you don't wait for the pitch. You anticipate it.
That's my kid.
That's my kid.
Did he hurt you?
That's my kid.
Hey!
Damn!
Well, that's my kid, and I'm gonna beat the out of whichever one of you is the father. Who's the father?
It's his kids. Look at him.
You just said it was your kid. Man.
Look at Kevin, him. Why are you out here bashing our son like that?
Look at him.
Damn!
You better stop. That ain't my kid, man. Please. Look at her. Look at me. Does it look like I'm gonna sleep with her? Come on, man. I can do better than that. Would you sleep with somebody with that wig? Oh!
Yes. Right? Juicely?
Pretty much what you were gonna do, right?
Previously on Real Husbands of Hollywood.
Let's just get this paper.
This is the love.
was a beautiful day to host a trunk show. And who better to invite than a bunch of my sophisticated, stylish...
Give me the jacket! Security! Regina!
King! Shopaholic girlfriends.
When are you gonna learn you're not a two anymore?
Well, all the zeros were taken.
All in all, things couldn't have been going better. That is until...
Tisha Campbell Martin?
Yes, may I help you?
Matt Keller, FBI. You're under arrest for real estate fraud and tax evasion.
Oh, wait, no,
you must be. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You have a right to an attorney.
I am her attorney. What is going on here?
If you don't back up, I got a pair of these for you, too.
Is that a threat?
Is there a problem here, officer?
Yeah, that dress is too small.
Oh, Mom Cop got a mouth.
You need to calm down.
I got you a fresh face. You ain't my
white
daddy.
You don't tell me what to do.
I play a DA on TV, okay? I don't know if you recognize me or not.
No, I do not.
But you need a warrant for this.
That's correct.
We have a warrant.
Okay. I played an attorney 4 seasons. I'll check this out.
I'm an actual attorney right now, so I'll look at it. Thank you.
Okay. Listen to me. I have played a DA as well, and I know for a fact that it is illegal to walk into a woman's trunk show and arrest her.
She busted him dead in his eye.
Did he just knock my $125,000 limited edition crocodile Durkin bag that was given to me by Leonardo DiCaprio on the floor? Oh, it is on.
Tisha Campbell Martin and 5 unidentified women have been arrested today at STUV restaurant in Hollywood. Now, this is all stemming from an ongoing investigation into the Church of the Beautiful, headed up by model, actor, turned spiritual guru, Boris Cujo.
Cujo!
And financial advisor, Duane Martin. Now, according to authorities, Cujo has left the country and Martin is unavailable for comment.
Oh, God. What kind of moonshine were you serving, teacher?
No, not taking responsibility for that. Learn how to hold your liquor, Lindsay Lohan.
So what did Boris say?
Not much of anything. He's on a silent retreat in Tibet.
Now, that's the stupidest shit I ever heard. What kind of grown-ass man goes to summer camp and doesn't speak?
I am so tired of hearing her big-ass mouth. Can we please send her to Tibet?
How much you want, Tibet? I will knock you in your
Get
damn mouth.
Of
you don't tell me what to do. What the f*** is that?
I'm sorry, that's just the sound I make when I get nervous.
Well, stop it, Lassie, because you're making us all nervous now.
All right, stop. Everybody, let's
you hear?
Please figure out how to get the hell up out of here now. Who hasn't made the phone call yet?
Her.
Oh, no. I would rather rot in jail than have this in my career.
Look here, Trina Shawshank. If you hadn't clocked that federal agent, none of us would be up in here, so this is your fault.
No. Do you remember why I clocked the federal agent? Because if it was not for you, Mrs. Duane, Shaky Real Estate Martin, none of us would be in here.
Well, you know what, Tisha? She got a point. And I ain't seen you make a phone call since we've been up in here.
Why don't you call Duane to get us out of here?
Because if I call him, I'm going to kill him, and then I'm going to be up in here for murder. And I am a classy lady.
Either you make the call or what?
Babe! Hey, I can't hear you. Okay.
Hey.
Hey, babe.
Where you been?
Babe, I got here as soon as I
could. Why are you even in jail, Duane?
I don't know, babe.
Somebody set you up.
Duane, you know something. I will come through that glass, I swear to God.
Okay, because man, you're gonna think this is crazy, right?
Tell me something.
So
somehow, like, your signature ended up on a document involved with the real estate shelter deal at Boris's church.
What?
Yeah, crazy, right?
Look, but I got it all under control. And I called Trina, and as soon as Trina calls me back, we're gonna get you out of here.
Trina's in here with me, you dumbass!
What?
Get me out of here, Duane. I miss my baby.
The kids are fine.
I'm talking about my wings. Someone needs to care for them and water them and sing to them. Who's gonna take care of Yossi? Yossi is a Malaysian Indian. I'm Euro-mixed. She is very sensitive.
Look at me. Breathe.
I just need to get out of here, baby.
I know, but they froze our accounts.
Oh, my God!
But baby, I called a friend.
Who? You called Will? Yes, this meant they make everything better.
Well, it's not Big Willie, but he is from Philly.
Who?
Hey, Tisha. Looks like your worst nightmare just came true. You gonna owe Kevin Hart, you hear me?
Oh, I will never owe Kevin Hart.
See that? That's why you in there looking all crazy now. Look like you've been drinking a bunch of punch.
That's what it look like. They in there whooping your ass, ain't they? It's because of your mouth.
Ain't nothing a few years in the old big house won't straighten up.
Oh, Tisha, real quick, speaking of straighten,
you might as well kiss that perm goodbye. In there, looking like James Brown mugshot.
I wouldn't.
Well, why not? She behind there. She gonna come through glass.
I wouldn't do that.
Oh, she don't look good.
Tisha look crazy. Tisha look crazy.
Gonna learn to die.
Help me, Duane.
You know, I was gonna bail you out, but now you know what? You and all your little wretched friends can spend the weekend in county.
No,
have fun, Tisha.
Wait. Kevin, you gonna let the mother of your children, two exes, and your lawyer go to jail because you hate me? Really, Kevin?
Well, how much would it be for me to pay y'all to get her out of here faster?
No.
Wait, get out.
Don't move.
Get out.
I hate you, Kevin Hart. I would kill both of y'all.
Tisha, I'll wait for you.
I don't understand. Where are they taking us?
They taking us to county.
No. There must be a mistake. My husband is on his way. Tell him the purse is in the freezer.
Look, it's too late. The court's just closed for the holiday weekend. He'll get you on Tuesday. Let's go.
Oh, my Lord.
Lord, take me now.
We can handle that. Low, untouchable. You ain't got the dough, son. I'm hoes, son. Crushing you.
Inside the joint, the walls begin to close on you fast, and you have to think quick to stay alive. And the only way for me to survive is to do what I do with Duane at home. Kick ass now and take names later. The others, well, they had their own ideas. All right, Trina, look, I know you got your legal degrees and all of that, but I'm gonna teach you how to survive in this Iron City. First of all, stay away from Bridget.
Why? She's a client.
No, she's a snitch.
Don't hate the rat just because you ain't got no cheese.
Did you save me those frijoles, huh? They're for me. Taste like
What's up, Nadine?
Don't call me Nadine.
The hell?
My name is Little Puppet now.
Oh, Little Puppet, huh? Oh, that's good. Because I pull strings. What?
I'm watching you, Pam.
Oh, it's funny, huh? It's funny. Come here. Let me holler at you for a second. Keep it up here. And I'm gonna tell your little chicas over there your ass went to private school.
In the short time we've been incarcerated, I've learned there are three things that can get you killed in prison. Stealing somebody's food, stealing somebody's woman, and admitting you went to a French immersion school. Parlez-vous français?
Oui.
Please, no.
Mm-hmm.
Please, no. Please, if you play, don't tell them, please.
I'll fuck you.
Get your ass away from me.
I'd never be caught.
Except today. Give me my phone. Give me my damn phone. I don't even know how you did it, but give me my damn phone. I saw you. Give me my phone, Regina.
You dropped it.
I didn't drop nothing. Your ass really should be in here. Thieving ass, Regina.
King.
Tisha thinks I was trying to steal her phone. I wasn't going for her phone. I was going for her wallet. A Martin residual.
Just stick with me, Trina, okay? And we'll get through this together.
Hey, Shaw, you got my
sh-? Yeah, ain't that what I'm known for? Getting sh-. Here's your wig glue. Now, where's my cup of noodle?
I said chicken.
The price just doubled. Now, if you don't get back here with my cup of noodle in the proper flavor, then your habeas corpus is gonna be all up in that cup. You got me? Get moving.
Who are you?
I'm the HBIC. Don't let the Ivy League degrees fool you. I represented Mystical, DMX, T.I., and Tiny. I am well-versed in prison economics. And in case you don't know what you're looking at, this is what $1 million looks like on the inside.
Nicole, stay away from Trina. Her ass is crazy. Where you get that Twinkie from?
Oh, from my new friend, Twinkie.
Who?
He's very nice.
No, Nicole! I told you, don't accept gifts from nobody in here!
Why?
Get Twinkie now!
Twinkie, Twinkie. Oh, I wanna
love you. Well, Nicole, no.
It's just a Twinkie.
No, Nicole, you don't get it.
Mellow yellow. Grab my pocket.
What?
I said grab it.
What am I supposed to do? All right, I'll figure something out. You make me sick. I'm always saving you. You know what? No, I'm not doing it. I'm not doing it. You better go ahead.
Well, the truth is, I figured I'd teach her a lesson and let Twinkie keep her dumb ass for a few hours. But never in a million years did I expect what was about to happen.
All right. Can I have everybody's attention? We got an announcement to make.
I want the queen, not the king.
Where's the count of planets?
Hey! Shut the f*** up and listen. Tonight, me and Mellow Yellow getting married.
What? No!
And we would like to invite you to the engagement party right now!
Congratulations! Now you got a husband on the inside and the outside. Yay!
I don't know how she does it. She getting married for the second time, and I'm trying to get married for the first.
And I'm telling you right now, I am feeling blue and pink, which means I see babies in your future.
Oh, my God.
But don't get up and sign a prenup, though. You want to get all of that money.
I do not want to do that.
Right. Are all of you crazy? You're just as nutty as this one. Come here, Nicole, let me holler at you.
What?
Have you lost your mind? Are you really getting married?
Tisha, we are gonna be in here for a while, and I don't really do the dating scene too well. I have to be in a committed relationship at all times.
To this woman?
That's the woman?
Where do you think you are?
I thought this was a co-ed facility, right? Like in my dorm at college. And besides, she has hair on her ass. What are you doing?
Nicole, how do you know this?
Because I took a shower with her.
Did you not see the front?
Well, you know what? It don't even matter, because love is love.
Well, she got a point there.
I agree. Love is love, but you're already married, Nicole.
She is married. I forgot about Boris.
I don't know how long Boris is going to hold out. I got to get you out of here. I got to get you out of this.
Fine, but I'm not giving back the ring.
Ooh. Girl, you came up.
Bridget, it's made out of hair. It's a nappy engagement ring. You don't even know where that came from.
Ew.
Oh.
But it's a thought that counts.
We got a problem over here.
Yeah, I got a problem. I got a problem with you trying to marry my girl.
Your girl? You better step back, homie. She belonged to me.
Look at her. She's pressing her balls up against her.
She's a lot of woman.
What? What?
Oh, that's what I thought. When I get back from my honeymoon on D Block, I'm gonna make you my side.
Girl, you about to get beat down.
After I beat Twinkie's ass, I'm gonna beat Nicole's ass. I can't believe she let herself get tricked into this marriage.
Well, believe it, T, because now the trick is on you. You see, Tisha can't resist being everybody's big sister. Plus, she likes to fight. So I knew she couldn't resist saving me from a bad marriage. But I told her one day, I'm gonna pay you back for putting pee-pee on me.
I told you. No, I don't do pee-pee.
Well, guess what? That day is here. Enjoy your Twinkie.
You want some of this? You want some of this? Then bring it.
Oh, yeah, I got it.
Bring it. Bring it.
What?
Bring it.
Oh, dance off?
Yeah.
We gonna
What's
dance?
Up? What's up?
Okay.
This is Jersey, yeah. Baby. You don't know nothing about that life.
Bring it, Jersey. Bring it, Jersey. Come on. Come on.
Oh, oh, oh.
Stop running.
What kind of soft-ass sponge cake is this?
No, gangster.
What?
I'm just a grad student with parking tickets.
So this tough girl act is just some bullshit?
Oh, yeah. I got off from watching Orange is the New Black.
Oh, I love that show.
Yeah, it's better than Game of Thrones.
It's a brilliant show.
Girl, you didn't tell me you watched that show. That's my show.
Oh, what? Nicole.
Who else is in here faking the orange? Damn, everybody?
I'm so scared.
I just wanna have some fun, some fun. I just wanna have some fun. I'm talking about hanging out.
Okay, let's talk about this $15. $14.99. Check forgery.
Bonjour.
Bonjour.
It's Tuesday morning. The slumber party's over. Out you go. Get out. You can stay. Everybody else, let's go.
Told you I would wait for you, baby.
Welcome home. Welcome home.
Yeah, yeah. Give me Yonsei.
Like I was saying, it was a beautiful day to do some time with my ratchet, thieving, alcoholic, down-ass girlfriends and Yonsei.
On Real Husbands of Hollywood.
Tisha Campbell-Martin, you're under arrest for real estate fraud and tax evasion.
This is all stemming from an ongoing investigation into the Church of the Beautiful, headed up by Duane Martin.
What?
Crazy, right?
What?
I'll wait for you!
Look, Kev, we've been dating. And he loves you better than I ever did.
Told you I would wait for you, baby.
Come in.
Hey, Kev.
Duane, what the hell are you doing here, man? It's 4:30 in the morning.
Yeah, I know. They let Tisha out of jail. Then she kicked me the fuck out.
What's that got to do with me, Duane?
Well, I was just hoping that I could stay with my best friend, man. You don't care about it. You're the only person that I came to about this.
Hey, Nicole. Tisha kicked me out. I need a place to stay.
Nelly, I need a place.
Hey, Nick. Listen, I need a... Mama.
Duane, do I look like I put the W in stupid?
What the hell? Duane.
Huh?
How the hell you... Yo, why is all this luggage in here?
Oh, that's my toiletries. Hey, Cap, thank you for letting me crash, man. Really appreciate it.
I'm not letting you crash here, Duane, so I don't know where you got that idea. Is that chili, man?
Yeah. Oh, wanna try?
Yeah. Oh, my God, that's good. That's really good. I see why Tisha got so big.
Wait till you see breakfast.
No. There ain't gonna be no breakfast, man. I don't hang out with thieves, Duane.
Okay,
sorry.
First of all, Kevin, I didn't steal anything.
Oh, stop it.
But look, all I did was I got some investors interested in backing Boris's church. Then all of a sudden, the feds started coming around and claiming embezzlement, tax evasion, racketeering. The bizarre thing about all of this is that all of the paperwork was in Tisha's name.
Actually, everything is in Tisha's name. Car, house, gym membership. But I'm the only one to use that.
Great chili, f***ed up story. You gotta go, Duane. I'm sorry. Gotta go. Duane. Oh, come on.
I got no place to go, Kev.
Okay, just stop it. Okay, you know where you can go? To the front desk, and you can go get you a room.
Tisha took my allowance.
What do you want from me, huh?
Oh, if you don't mind, I invited some people over.
I'm sorry, what?
I invited some people over. Is it cool?
Is it cool? You invited people to my house at 4:30 in the morning, man? God.
Good morning, Mr. Hart.
Are you ready for your massage therapy?
Yeah. If you go right, straight back. Just go straight to the back.
To the deep end?
Yeah. You got 2 days. One for each girl, and then you're gone.
That's all I asked for. Couple of days, brother.
Y'all ever use chili?
This track is fire, Bridget. We're gonna win with this one.
I don't know if I can do it. Stop.
Yes, you can. You can do this. And just like Mariah, Whitney, and all them when they got started, you just laying foundation. That's all. I wrote this song just for you. You hear me? My little songbird. Oh.
You know what I love about you?
What's that?
You believe in me.
You know what I love about you?
What?
Your big old personality.
Yo, this has been like one of the coolest relationships I ever had. No expectations. She do her thing, I do my thing. I can get used to this.
This relationship is amazing. Much better than the one I had with Mighty Mouse. I'm into him and he's into me. So this is what monogamy feels like. I could get used to this.
Good afternoon, Mr. Hart. Would you care for orange juice or coffee?
Who the hell are you as wears peaches and cream?
Peaches and cream send their regrets, sir. They had another appointment.
Duane! It's an old white man in my room!
That's Coleman, your new butler.
Okay, this is weird, man. You got to go.
Very good, sir. I will await you in the bath.
You don't have to follow me, man. Whoa. Hey, Shake. What's going on? Why was people in my house?
We were waiting for you, Kevin. I've been wanting to introduce you to Team Hart.
What?
This is your script reader. She found all of Tom Cruise's movies, the ones that worked. This is your new assistant.
Hey.
Okay? This is your new chef.
Oh, okay.
All right? This is your trainer, and this is your new security.
Shake, come here, because I feel like I met everybody. Is there a way where we can possibly get these people to f*** out my house? It's too early. It's too early.
Are you serious?
Yes, I'm serious. I don't want strangers.
Do you understand what's happening right here? This is Team Hart. You need a team to get where you're going, man. Kevin, I don't want you to think of Kevin Hart as only just a brand. I want you to think of yourself as a franchise, right? Like Hart Bucks or Walhart. All right, okay. You ready for this one? Hart Donalds.
That hit me.
Huh?
That hit me.
I knew
that hit me.
Hart Donalds?
No, that's good. I like McDonald's.
You feel me on that?
I like McDonald's.
Home of the Little Mac?
Okay, all right. You got my attention. Duane is good. He's so good.
I need you to hurry up and get dressed. We got a meeting at Sony. You're at the top of the list for Iron Man.
Cheetah's out?
Downey.
What?
Huh?
Wait a minute. Hold on.
You can thank me later.
Wait a minute. Downey?
Yes. Did I earn my rent now?
Look at my face.
You do. Watch it. We need your face right.
Kevin Hart's room, please. No, I don't know his alias.
Honey,
I need to talk to you.
Hey, listen, Tisha.
What?
Stop. We're working right now. We don't have the time.
Kevin, move, okay? I need to talk to my husband.
Listen, what you gonna do is talk to me. You got to talk to me.
Talk to you about what?
Talk to me. Reality is, that's not your husband no more. You fired him, I hired him, baby.
Look, I don't have time for your little games, okay? So off your little...
We're done here. Let's go, guys. Let's go, guys.
Babe, please come home. I can't find the kids.
Tisha,
what?
Stop. First of all, you're a bad parent. Let's just throw it out there.
I'm not denying that.
Okay. Second of all, he wants a test.
I don't know
if those babies are his.
Wait, what?
Yeah, I never said anything to you, but they don't look like him. Let's just nip that in the bud now.
Oh, my God.
Last but not least, you gave him up. He belongs to me.
He belongs to who?
I didn't want
to
do this, but you left me the choice. Fellas.
Babe, you're going to...
Get rid of it.
Get rid of who? Who is he talking about?
Turned out dope. Like that
thing? Yeah. It was good. It was really good.
Ooh, girl, you sang that.
Thanks, Tamar. I was just doing what you told me to do.
I ain't tell you to try to sing better than me, though.
Wow, you sound amazing.
Thank you. That means a lot. I'm a fan.
Oh, thank you. Nelly,
hey.
Keep in touch.
Aight.
All right, thanks.
Yeah, no problem.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Tamar, let's hang out sometime, girlfriend.
I'm all right.
You really think that she meant what she said?
Yo, she loved it. We sold her the song, yes.
What song?
The song you just sang the hell out of. You don't remember me telling you, that's L. You know, I've been trying to sell her a song since she was nominated for a Grammy, and we did it today, baby.
Yeah, wait. But my song, the one you wrote for me? Because you told me I was the only one who could sing that song, Nelly.
Yeah.
Ooh, Nelly, you tried it like that.
Excuse me. Listen, don't worry about that, B. I got 1,000 songs you can sing. We'll cut another one tomorrow.
Yeah, but you wrote that one
Ooh,
for
baby,
me.
Ooh, baby, I'm gonna tell you something. Girl, don't fall for that. That ain't Babyface, okay?
And you ain't Tony.
And you a rapper, though, okay? You're not a songwriter.
Okay, look, Tamar, can I please have a moment with Bridget, please?
Sure. But, girl, let me tell you something. You better watch your song and get your life.
How about you just get the door?
How about you have several seats?
All right. And give Inspector Gadget back his hat. Listen, don't be like that. She has no family values, all right? We said we was gonna keep it 100. I could've went behind your back, but that's what we're doing. We're keeping it true, all right? Right?
Yeah, that's what we're doing. Oh, I'ma keep it 100, all right. Nelly got 99 problems, and this bitch is too.
Good afternoon, Mr. Hart.
Hey, Coleman.
You're regular? Brown liquor on the rocks?
Oh, you know I like it. Coleman, I'm tired, man. Is that bed ready?
I'd say so, sir. Peaches and cream are in position with a massage table.
Hello.
Okay, then call me back when you get it right.
Who's that?
Some small-time insurance company wants you to replace a damn duck as their spokesperson. I told them we need $3 million or they can duck off.
Well, did you call my agent?
Come on, man, who needs a stinking agent? We can keep that 10% in the house.
What do you mean we?
Okay,
Shay, you know what? After I get my massage, man, you and I, we're gonna have to have us a talk, okay?
Oh, I sent the girls home.
I'm sorry, you did what?
I sent them home.
You sent the girls?
I was not aware of this, sir. Shall I retrieve the young ladies?
You damn right you should retrieve the
Coleman,
young ladies.
Don't move.
Coleman, move.
No.
Yes.
No.
Go.
Look, Cav, we need you to focus, man. We have our second meeting with Iron Man tomorrow. Do you understand what this can mean to us?
Yes.
We're talking sequels, Cav.
No, you're right. You're 100% right. You know what?
All right.
Coleman,
you feel me?
Do me a favor. Prepare me the same steak he has, man.
Cav.
What is going on?
How are you going to be Iron Man with a doughboy body?
Hmm?
You're juicing.
I'm not juicing, man. I want a damn steak. And you know what? Coleman, you call Peaches and Cream right now.
So you can sweat it off, sir. They are quite athletic.
Or you give him a raise. Now!
Yeah, this is the fight of the year now. Y'all get ready. Matter of fact, yo, I tell you what, all y'all running your mouth, put your money where your mouth is. Right here, come on. Let me have it. Let me have it. Boy, ain't no rent getting paid by you. Kiss a goodbye.
Hey. Oh, he scared me.
Oh, yeah? Does that mean I can't have a kiss? Woo. Let me get some of this chicken.
What are you doing? I got you.
You got me? Oh. That's what I'm talking about. Told the fellas you weren't gonna be tripping about no damn song.
Boy, please, I'm not even thinking about that little song.
But they did tell me.
You could always make me laugh, Kevin.
Okay. I expect her to blow up just now. That's a big difference right there.
I'm glad.
No! No!
No! Oh.
No! Oh.
Hey, Mooja, try some of this chicken, my brother.
That's good.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Let me keep it.
No, it's full. You gotta get your own. I told you the boys had you read wrong. The luckiest man in the world.
I want you on, baby. Don't you know I've had enough? Oh, oh. Make yourselves a plate, fellas.
I trust your audition went well, Mr. Stark.
Coleman, went well is an understatement. I killed it. You hear me? Nailed it, Coleman. Do you know how big this is? To have a black superhero? This is huge. They already fit me for my arc reactor.
Oh, quite impressive, sir. Just don't fly away before dinner.
What? It's not real, man.
Apparently, neither was my attempt at sarcasm, sir.
I don't get it.
Yeah, well, when you're ready to sit down and talk for real, call us. Until then, don't.
Dude, I think I really killed that audition.
I know you killed it. That was the studio on the phone.
I'm sorry, what? You were just yelling at the studio like that?
Yeah. They tried to lowball us, man. I told them I had to be executive producer. If I'm not executive producer, we're not doing it.
What did you say? What did you just say? Just
Dad,
now.
What are you talking about, Kev? I'm saving you money, man. This is how you get to production to pay for your manager. It's done all the time.
Dave Becky is my manager.
Ex-manager.
What?
I fired him this morning. Look, Kev, we can take that 15% and keep it in-house. Are you kidding me? Look, I know you don't know what to say right now, but you can thank me later. As a matter of fact, I'm gonna go fire the publicist because I'm the one that got you the cover of Ebony. We can take that 5% and keep that in-house. We don't need these people.
Okay, it's time to get rid of Duane. Might as well keep that 90% in-house.
Yo, that's it, man. One more person.
Oh, boy. What's up, baby?
You was about to get worked.
Oh, man, come on, man.
What's up with you?
About to check in, you know, lay low for a few days.
Bridget tried to kill you, didn't she?
How you know? She told you? You was there. Why didn't you tell me?
What you, I did tell you. You don't listen. That's your problem.
Thought y'all was a couple of freaks.
You was no freaks. I was running for my damn life. What you do, cut your brakes? Put glass in your cereal? Dynamite candle?
dynamite candle.
Yeah, she stole that one from the Roadrunner. And just like the Roadrunner, she won't quit. What? I suggest you watch your back, boy.
I ain't worried about it. St. Louis, baby, I got
her attack. All
right. You know.
Hey, what's up, Bridget?
Oh!
Mimi.
It's not funny.
Mitch.
I didn't mention the Acme safe. I didn't want to scare it. Mimi.
Why am I here, Kevin?
Hey, Tish, listen, I want to talk to you about our situation.
Situation?
First of all, what you and Duane have is special. Let's just get that out the way.
Stop. You trying to pass Shake back on to me?
Tish.
So now you want to get rid of his sneaky, trifling, interfering ass. Well, guess what, Kevin? The police called. They found my kids.
What?
And I'm making his mama babysit, too. I don't need his ass.
Okay, Tish.
I don't need him.
Tish, listen, you need to come get him. He's ruining my life. My career is falling apart because of him. I see why your career fell off.
What?
At one point, you were the top grossing female on television. And now, that's gone. I know why, because he feeding you, you got big. And look at you now, Tisha. Tisha, this
just is for that, you could keep his ass.
Tisha,
no, hell no.
Listen to me.
Uh-uh.
Tisha,
no, negotiations off the table.
Stop it. Stop it. Please. What do you want? I swear I'll get it. Okay, wigs. I'm talking about the good ones. The ones like Beyonce, not these little cheap witness protection ones that you wear. How about I make this little singing dream of yours a reality and put some good money into that false career? You can have it, Tisha.
Keep your money, Kevin Hart, please.
Tisha, whatever you want.
Anything?
Oh, God. You want sex.
Oh, that was so good. That was amazing. That's what we needed, baby. Just some time alone away from the kids. Oh, I love you. Are you crying again?
It's so good.
Okay.
It's so good.
You wanna eat, babe?
Okay.
No, not that. Not again. I'm exhausted. Are you kidding me? Get away from me.
Rang, ma'am. I can smell that you two made up.
Shut the hell up, Kevin.
Shut the hell up, Kevin.
Go make us some eggs Benedict.
Yes. And some fruit spritzers.
You, no one understands you when you like this, honey. And some fruit spritzers, Kevin.
Yes.
With the soda stream, Kevin.
Okay. You little bitch.
Yeah, he is a mix.
Well, which one, Bridget? Look, girl, I'm not trying to kill him. I just want to get him. Give him the runs a little bit, that's all. Give him diarrhea, right? Shut up, you laughing. Hey, you really are a witch. I'm dead serious. So y'all gonna hook the cable up tomorrow. Thank you. I was just about to get your soda stream ready. So what I'm gonna do is a special little mix for you. It's apple mango and orange pineapple. I call it my suicide mix. Okay, so that's gonna be done. And I got your eggs. Ignore this green stuff on it. That's just for flavor.